This problem says some people use the letters FOIL, or FOIL, as a strategy for making sure they have multiplied all the terms. Use the FOIL approach to multiply 3x plus 2 times 5x minus 7. I'm going to say let you know just from the get-go, I personally don't like FOIL, because it's kind of just, it's a mnemonic to kind of memorize steps, and you really don't know what you're doing. But since this problem says use FOIL, I guess we'll use FOIL. So let's just use FOIL. So FOIL stands for, that's why I hate these mnemonics, because as soon as you're done with the test, you're going to forget this, and when you're 30 years old, you're not going to even remember what FOIL stands for, especially how to apply it. But it stands for first, outside, inside, and last. And the whole point of it is to make sure that you multiply every term in this first expression with every other term in the last expression. Now, the reason why you're doing it is you're really just doing the distributive property twice. And I'll do that later in this video, because I really dislike just memorizing FOIL. But since we have it written there, let's do it. So first says let's multiply the two first terms. So first, let me do it in different colors. The first terms, two first terms, was a 3x and a 5x. So you multiply the 3x times the 5x. Then the outside says multiply the outside numbers. So multiply the 3x and the negative 7. So notice we've multiplied the 3x times the 5x, and now we're going to multiply the 3x times the negative 7. So plus 3x times negative 7. That's the outside. Then it tells you to do the inside. So we'll do the inside numbers are the 2 and the 5x. So plus 2 times 5x. And then L stands for last, or the last numbers, or 2 times negative 7. Plus 2 times negative 7. And now we just have to simplify. 3x times 5x is 15x squared. Plus 3x times negative 7 is negative 21x. 2 times 5x is 10x. And then you have 2 times negative 7 is negative 14. And now we can combine these middle two terms right here. If I have negative 21x, and then I'm adding 10x to that, that takes me back to negative 11x. So this is negative 11x. And we have the 15x squared out front. 15x squared minus 11x minus 14. Which is the product of these two expressions. So FOIL does give you the right answer, but it's just not always obvious why you're doing all of these different combinations of multiplications. But this is the right answer. But what I want to do is take a side here to just show you that as long as you just knew the distributive property, you could have done this problem. You did not have to know FOIL. And this way, you'll never forget it. So if I'm going to multiply 3x plus 2 times 5x minus 7, what you can think about is this is just some number here. And if I'm multiplying it times this expression, I can just distribute it onto this expression. If this was just a, if this was just a 2, we would say, OK, this is the same thing as 2 times 5x plus 2 times negative 7. That's what the distributive property is. So let's just distribute it out. We have to just multiply this whole thing. Multiply this whole thing times each of those terms. That's just the distributive property. So you get 3x plus 2 times 5x, I could write the 5x out front here. So that's just that times that. And then you're going to have plus 3x plus 2. And then you have 3x plus 2 times the second term, times negative 7. Now I could just put a negative plus here and a negative 7. Or I could say it's negative 7 times 3x plus 2. So it's 5x times 3x plus 2 minus 7 times 3x plus 2. This was just the distributive property. Now, again, we can apply the distributive property to get the 5x times each of these terms. So this is going to be 5x times 3x times 3x plus 5x times 2 plus 5x times 2. Just doing the distributive property on this. Now we do it again here. So then we have minus 7, or negative 7 times 3x. So minus 7 times 3x times 3x. And then negative 7 times 2. So minus 7 times 2. And what do we get? Let's scroll down a little bit. I'll do these in a neutral color. We get 5x times 3x is 15x squared. 5x times 2 is 10x. 7 times 3x is minus 21x. And then negative 7 times 2 is minus 14. And just like we saw up here, these two terms can be merged into 10x minus 21x is negative 11x. So we get 15x squared minus 11x minus 14. Could have done it just doing the distributive property twice, which you're less likely to forget when you're 30 years old. Or if you like, you can memorize FOIL.